Before we start, quick shout out to our friends at insights.gg. They have a platform to help players improve their performance with VOD review tools as well as Valorant map overlays and agent icons. If you're serious about getting better, create a free account today. Any game that you can win in will have players that try to achieve that win by whatever means necessary. To most, that means developing a deeper understanding of the game and honing their skills. To others, that means installing a program that does the work for them. In order to try and level the playing field in online games, anti-cheat software is necessary. But more often than not, it inadvertently creates a substandard experience for those playing normally by the rules, either by taking up computer resources or being overly invasive. In this video, we will discuss the hotly debated anti-cheat software in Valorant, Vanguard, how it compares to others on the market, and how it's pushing the boundaries of what an anti-cheat should and should not do. It's important to start off by saying that with current computing standards, no anti-cheat will ever be perfect. It's much easier to develop software that abuses an exploit or a hole in the game's code versus creating an airtight game with no security flaws. Every competitive game goes through this cheater versus developer's arm race, but it will invariably end up in the cheater's favor. If so, then you might think, why have anti-cheat at all? If there's no hope in completely quelling bad actors, then why dampen the experience for everyone else, all for the few that choose to cheat? The answer is, any line of defense is better than no line at all. While the ideal goal of anti-cheat is to stop players outright, and that's how the developers will advertise it as such to instill confidence, the real goal is to put up as many barriers and obfuscation as possible to make it hard for cheats to be developed in the first place. Vanguard, Valorant's anti-cheat, has been under a lot of heat for its incredibly aggressive and arguably invasive methods to prevent cheaters. Everything from its always-on nature to its invisible disabling of unsecured drivers on the player's computer is pretty unusual from what we have come to expect from similar solutions. One of the first robust anti-cheat programs was Punkbuster, developed by Even Balance. It was used notably in around 80% of every Quake 3 and Return to Castle Wolfenstein matches. Punkbuster has both a client and a server-side anti-cheat, meaning that even having control over the client entirely, a cheater would need to do additional work to spoof the information being sent to the server. If a player was caught cheating in a server that uses Punkbuster, they would be banned from all servers using that service. Punkbuster could also institute hardware bans based on unsecure computer components, and block the player from the servers based on those. Another notable anti-cheat solution in early 2002, Valve opted out of using an already made anti-cheat solution and sought to create their own to combat the ever-growing cheating epidemic in the original Counter-Strike. Valve Anti-Cheat, or VAC as it's more commonly referred to, uses much of the same methods of both client and server-side cheat detection, although it more heavily leans on the server side of the equation. A notable VAC scandal happened in late 2014, when it was reported that it was sending users DNS caches, basically a list of websites that you have previously connected to Valve servers. Gabe Newell had to release a public statement that the DNS cache was accessed in order to catch kernel-level cheats, that contacted the servers to verify whether the user had actually paid to use the cheat or not. He also said that this method was only used for 13 days until the cheat producers discovered it and started to manipulate the DNS cache of their customers. Newell went on to state that in those 13 days, 570 cheaters were banned using this technique, and that VAC tries to look like a scary and opaque system in order to make attacks against it more difficult. This method of having the software be perceived as something to be feared and complicated is more commonly known as security through obscurity, an idea that is perpetuated by the fact that cheaters on VAC are not banned immediately, but rather in waves together all at once, making it harder for cheaters to establish what exactly it was that got them caught. This system proved to be effective, and is still how many games handle banning cheating players today. Another notable anti-cheat solution was Warden, created by Blizzard Entertainment for World of Warcraft. It had its own scandal in 2006 when it was discovered that the program was scanning users' browser history and cookies. Later, it was also revealed that the software was scanning the names of running programs and checking them against a list of cheating software, and even sending certain emails it deemed suspicious back to Blizzard. This, much like all anti-cheat software scandals, came and was ultimately forgotten. Most companies that employ these invasive measures usually cover themselves with the terms of service that users agree to when they first install the games that they are a part of. Because of this, no real legal action can be taken, because technically the player has signed off on these kinds of measures when installing them. This brings us to Vanguard, another anti-cheat solution in another competitive video game. One of the headlines that's been making the rounds is that Vanguard runs on Ring Zero or kernel level privilege on your PC. Without getting deep into what exactly a program running on Ring Zero does or does not have access to, just know that it's one of the highest levels of privilege that you can give to a program on your computer. Understandably, any anti-cheat software wants to have its roots deep into your PC to prevent cheaters from doing the things they do, from editing memory data to reading and modifying network packets. While there has been some not unreasonable concern pointed at Riot for running this high privilege program on your PC, what's perhaps important to note is that you may have already installed a similar anti-cheat that does pretty much the same thing. If you have played any popular PC game in the last 5 to 10 years, chances are with or without knowing you have installed BattleEye or Easy Anti-Cheat onto your system. Both of these anti-cheats are probably the most popular solutions for game developers currently, and both run on Ring Zero kernel level privilege on your computer. Just like Vanguard, these anti-cheats need to root themselves deep in order to track and catch any cheating that might happen. Privacy is a completely reasonable concern, and as told before, anti-cheats are not without their share of scandals and breaches of privacy. However, it's important to note that software does not need this level of privilege on your computer to steal valuable information. Many Ring 2 or 3, or more commonly known as user-level applications, have the same level of privilege to access files, steal data, and do a bunch of invasive things. So a lot of what Riot is doing with Vanguard is standard practice. But what isn't is having the anti-cheat running on boot, even if the user isn't playing Valorant. This is perhaps the most controversial aspect of Vanguard. While many anti-cheats in the past have had their scandals, the scanning of private data usually happens during gameplay, as the anti-cheat running during actual play seems like the most logical time. Vanguard tries to take this a step further, with its security lead stating that running on boot will make it harder for cheat developers to start their software before Vanguard. Regardless of the fact if it actually makes it that much harder for cheaters to write programs for Valorant, many users have reported Vanguard shutting off drivers that it deems unsecure without notification, or causing frame drops when unrelated games are running. These issues could potentially be forgiven if they only happened when the game itself was running, but because of Vanguard's always-on nature, they happen silently and without any warning. Most notably were several reports that Vanguard would block and shut off PC fan controllers on startup without notifying the user, causing their setups to overheat and eventually shut off. Granted, these fan controllers were being run on unsecure drivers, but the security through obscurity that Vanguard and most anti-cheats employ made troubleshooting this particular issue for innocent users unnecessarily difficult. The silver lining is that Vanguard is a brand new piece of software, and even with all of its bad press, Riot has been dialing back the aggressiveness slowly. It still launches at boot, but you can now unload it at any time. This might be from the pushback that Vanguard has been getting, or it might have been a planned feature that was going to be included anyways. But regardless, these are steps in the right direction. The whole topic does bring up an interesting point though. If the collective gaming public is mostly fine with this always-on anti-cheat solution, why don't other developers start doing the same thing? What if Activision, Valve, or Epic Games decide that they also want the luxury of an always-on anti-cheat to combat the problem in their own games? All of a sudden, we're looking at a future where you have 4 or 5 anti-cheats running at all times, hopefully not conflicting with each other and not resource-hogging on your PC. The slippery slope aside, Vanguard is here to stay. If you're not happy with the measures Riot is taking, let them know directly through a social channel, because otherwise for now, your only option is to uninstall Valorant. Riot Games is probably the biggest games developer in the world, and they have a lot to lose doing something like stealing your banking info and selling it to China or something similar, so it's fairly unlikely that something like that would happen intentionally. The unfortunate reality is that cheaters lessen the experience for all parties involved. Innocent players who have to deal with the unintended consequences of anti-cheat software, and developers that have to allocate resources just making the game be fair for all players. Is Vanguard too aggressive of a cheating solution? Perhaps, but at the end of the day, your privacy is under your control. If you're not comfortable with Vanguard, then you will have to miss out on Valorant.